In this video, I'm gonna show you how to do a 90s retro inspired design like this one right here. I'm gonna show you how to do it step by step. You can follow along and I'm gonna do it all in Canva. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juna with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005. And in this video, I wanna show you how to design a 90s inspired t-shirt. So I'm gonna show you how to do this step by step. We're gonna go into Canva. They have a lot of graphics there. You could draw your own graphics and use your own different fonts, but since Canva has a lot of these graphics already, I'm gonna try and show you how to do it there. Of course, you can get your graphics anywhere on the internet. If you wanna go to Vexels, you wanna go to Creative Fabrica, and all those places, there's a ton of different places to get them from. You can use some of these same techniques that I'm gonna show you in Canva to do it in Affinity Designer, Illustrator, or Photoshop, whatever your graphic design app that you use, you can do it in that. So let's get into Canva right now and I'll show you how to do it. So here we are on Canva, canva.com. You can see I have the pro version, but don't worry, we're gonna use some of the free stuff there. And you can always use some of the free stuff even if I use some of the pro stuff. So you can swap those out. You don't have to follow my design exactly the way I'm doing it, but you can use a lot of the techniques that I'm gonna show you how to do. So first, let's create a design. Let's go here. And then I like to hit custom size. I already have 4,500 by 5,400. So I'm gonna click on this. If you don't have that, you can type in here 4,500 by 5,400 pixels is what I'm gonna use. And boom. All right, the first thing I'm gonna do is find some 90s text. Now, if you're a beginner, I would suggest that you do that first, is to type out your text first, then we can put things around and kind of fill the space. Like, this is a very simple way to create a design if you're a beginner. So I'm gonna show you how to do it. We're gonna just type in T, or click the button T for text. And I'm gonna type in, you can use any phrase that you want, but I'm gonna keep it really simple and say, this is my, and I'm gonna make this bigger and kind of fit the whole thing. And it's gonna be, this is my 90s costume. So I'm gonna click on this and hold down option and drag for copy and drag for copy. So this one will say 90s and this one will say costume. All right, so let's find a 90s font. So one of the fonts that I like using is Costa Rica for 90s. And it's just because it's nice and square. So in the 90s, they used either square or rounded, kind of a retro look. So I'm gonna do this all caps. And the way you can do that is right here, uppercase. And I'm gonna fill the space. This is gonna help me fill the tall rectangle, right? So I'm gonna go up here and just fill the space like that. See how it's going almost edge to edge. We don't need to go all the way edge to edge because we're gonna do some things later. You could go all the way edge to edge if you wanted to. So we're gonna change these as well to Costa Rica, and this one to Costa Rica, and this one as well for uppercase. So let's fill the space here as well. We can make sure that this is the same width as that one right there, and just hold shift to make sure it doesn't move and drag it down. And 90s is gonna be like that. We can make this as big or small as we want. 90s is kind of the star of this design, so I'm gonna make it bigger because that's the focal point, is 90s. This is my 90s costume, right? The next thing I wanna do is kind of fill the space. So we're gonna go into here to elements and then type in 90s just to see what kinds of things are here, and go to graphics. And you could choose any one of these things. I'm just gonna choose some things at random. Put this here. Let's see what else. I like these triangles. We'll save those for later. Let's see what else we got here. Let's scroll down. This is kind of cool. See, I'm just filling the space with random 90s things, right? What about this lightning bolt? Boom. And then for variety, let's do one more thing here. One of the things you can do is, like, when you click on this, you're gonna see more or see all. So now you can see kind of the same family. We don't need the second one. Let's see, what would we put in here? Maybe this tape right here, cassette tape. And we can play with size, right? There were a lot of triangles and round shapes in the 90s. So I'm gonna take this, hold down option, and kinda turn this around here. Let's see, maybe down here as well. I'm gonna take this out and put this triangle here. Turn it the other way. Cool. All right, and then we're gonna fill the space with other things. So let's look for like smaller things, maybe a star. Let's go back. Oh, this could be cool, this wavy line. It's kind of neat. These stars are neat. I'm just gonna do star, I think. 90s star, here's a 90s star, or there. These are all cool 90s stars. So let's just do some of these. Let's see. Just for some scale, let's put this in the back. So you see we're filling up the space here. Holding down option and copying these stars. Kind of twisting them. Good, I think we filled the space enough. We could do one more small thing here, maybe a circle or something. We could just do, let's do 90s circle. Again, you can pick whatever one you want. I could have picked this, you know. Let's do this circle. Cool. And 90s also overlapped a lot of things. So you can see things are behind and things are in front and so on. Maybe this one's in the front. All right, this is pretty good. We're gonna put this on a black shirt. So let's type this here. But if this goes on a black shirt, then this text is gonna have to be a different color. So let's click on this, click a different color, maybe just that for now. And now let's click on the background. Make sure that the shirt is black. Hey, that's looking good already. Some of the black things in here are not standing out. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click on the black here and just make it like a different color. So instead of black, do this darker color. I think this one has black as well. Oh, this one can't edit the color. Whoops. You might wanna check one that can edit colors. When you do yours, just make sure that you pick one that's can change the color. One thing that would be cool on here as well is, well, let's change these. I think these have black as well. Let's do that. And these, all these stars don't change color either. You're gonna have to look for that when you do it. One more thing that I was gonna say is you can use some of these colors that are in here. We're already using this yellow, but we can use some of the other ones. So let's go in through here. You can see these are the document colors. So we can go ahead and kind of pick the colors here, kind of randomly, you know. Okay, I think that's a little more fun, right? So just pick whatever color you want. Doesn't matter. Okay. So this is 90s were really colorful. So let's color each one of these letters as well. So just random. And so on. Another thing the 90s was known for is kind of tilting things on its side. So even this right here, we're gonna turn it. So let's turn it just a little bit like this, right? And that way we can turn this one and then maybe turn this 90s like that. So it's this one. And there you go. So you can have fun with this. Put things in the back, put things in the front, color different things. You can swap out stuff, like I said, if you don't like this one because you can't color it, come in here, you know, can you color this one? Yeah. So maybe you put that instead on here. Just have fun with the different graphics. Overlap them, have fun with the colors, the nice neon colors, tilt them and things like that. And you can see, you can have fun. And you can add more small things, like if you want to add like this element in it, you know, put that in the back. Or if that's too much, maybe that's too much. Let's not do that. Maybe we just want circles. So the way to do circles, I believe, is C. I'm going to do other circles here, so. Right, with different colors. Maybe this one's yellow. Come in here and use the, things like that. So there you go. This is my 90s costume. I'm just using all the different graphics from here. There's so many graphics when you type in 90s. And some of them are pro, but some of them are free. Like, I believe this one was free. Yeah, so you can see some of the things that I used on here were free stuff. You can even go and do, like, if you want to use this 90s instead of that 90s, that can kind of be good too. So have fun with this. Really easy to do in Canva. And I didn't even use some of these other ones. Like, look at this thing here. Just so many 90s things, right? Got the scrunchie. The Walkman would have been cool. Let's see if we can fit that guy in. Look at that. Walkman like that. That's really 90s. So just have fun with this. Use the different colors from the graphics in your text. And make sure to use a text that looks very retro. There's lots of different ones in here. This one that I'm using again is Costa Rica, if you want to use that. And have fun with the colors. Make sure you tilt stuff. Things front and back. Use triangles and all those different techniques. So hopefully this was really helpful for you so that you can make your own 90s design. It doesn't have to say this is my 90s costume. In fact, you probably shouldn't do that. Just do something totally different, right? Go do some research. You may want to use the word 90s in there, but there's lots of different phrases that you can use with the words 90. I'm a 90s child, born in the 90s. This is my 90s whatever. Brainstorm, make sure to come up with your own thing, and make sure to use your own, different graphics than mine, and lay it out in a different part. Don't put the glasses right here. If you want to put it here, whatever, right? Change it up, make it your own, and have fun with this. And now that I got this, if you have Canva Pro, which is really cool, you can go in here and hit download, transparent background. It will take away the black background when I do this. So when I hit download now, you're going to see this is my 90s costume. And if I open it up here, you can see that the background is already knocked out, is ready to go, ready to put on merch by Amazon and Redbubble and all the different POD sites. So we did it very quickly, and you can do the same thing with different genres. You can do this for 80s, do an 80s search. If you can do it for 2000s and so on, 60s, 70s. There's so many different graphics here in Canva. So have fun with this idea and make it your own, and hopefully get lots of sales this Q4. So that is it for this video. Thanks so much for watching. If this video was really helpful for you, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed to this channel already, make sure to hit that subscribe button right there. The question of the day for this video is, have you made a 90s inspired t-shirt design before? If you have, let me know that in the comments. If you haven't, also let me know that in the comments. I think 90s t-shirt designs do really well still on Amazon and some of the other print-on-demand sites. Thanks again for watching, and if you want to see more t-shirt tutorials, make sure to click on these videos right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.